you got here just in time. Gordon's down the street, and he's gonna play a dirty trick on Ernie.
Monster, now look, see this bell? When I ring this bell, I want you to come up, and I want you to take this flute and play it.
Oh, okay, a cookie.
Cookie?
Cookie?
Cookie. I'll give you a cookie after you play the flute.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Cookie.
Good, cookie. Okay, now, hello, Ernie. Hello, Ernie.
Hello there, Gordon.
How are you?
Oh, fine, thank you.
All ready for the game?
Yes, yes. Okay, what game are we playing today?
Well, we're playing a game called What Will Happen.
What Will Happen?
What Will Happen.
Oh, I can't wait to play it.
Okay.
How do you go?
How's it go?
Mm-hmm.
Show you. This is a ball.
That's a ball?
Verify that?
Sure.
That's a ball.
Sure, that's a ball.
What happens if I let it go? What will happen?
If you let that ball go, it will drop. And it will fall to the ground and possibly bounce.
You sure about that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
You were absolutely right, Ernie.
Sure.
You're batting one for one.
Sure.
You know that?
Mm-hmm.
Ready for the second one?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. This is...
a radio.
You knew it.
Yeah.
You knew it. Boy, you're smart.
Mm-hmm.
If I turned it on,
yeah,
what would happen?
Well... the radio will go on,
right,
and then we will hear either news or music or whatever's on the radio.
You're going to stick by that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll try it. Turn it on.
And now for the weather report. The weather for today is expected to be warm and pleasant, unless, of course, it becomes cloudy and unpleasant.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't?
Sure.
All right.
Sure.
Now, you were right twice.
Sure.
One more.
Okay.
One more. One more.
Yeah.
That's a bell.
Oh, there's a bell.
There's a bell.
Mm-hmm.
Ernie, if I pick up that bell and shake it, what will happen?
If you pick up that bell and shake it, the bell will ring.
Okay, and what else?
What do you mean, what else?
Well, I mean, what else happens after it rings?
Well, I don't know. You pick up a bell, you shake it, the bell rings. That's all.
No, well, you know, usually when I pick up a bell and shake it, a monster comes up and appears and starts blowing a flute.
A monster comes up and starts blowing a flute? Oh, I've never heard of anything as silly as that.
Well, that's what I'm sorry, Ernie, but that's what happens. If you pick up a bell and shake it, a monster comes up and starts blowing a flute.
Oh, if that's what you think, Gordon, you just go ahead and ring that bell. A monster with a flute, that's the silliest thing I've ever heard of.
One, two, and a...
the monster playing a flute, Gordon.
Yeah, I know, just like I said. Right.
Well, it's great.
Played flute, cookie.
You want a cookie?
Cookie!
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Gordon. There's something tricky going on here, isn't there?
Well...
you had it all fixed, didn't you?
Yeah.
You gave him a cookie to play his flute when he heard the bell, didn't you? Huh?
Cookie!
Okay, but I didn't give him a cookie yet.
Here,
take your cookie, monster.
Oh, it was a big
trick. Monster cookie. Yeah.
That's all it was.
Yeah,
was a trick.
Yeah, well... yeah.
That's a good trick, Gordon.
You like it?
Yeah,
okay,
that's a nice trick.
You know something, Ernie? You're a good sport. You really are a good sport.
Oh, I enjoy those tricks.
Okay. Look, you played a good game. We'll see you later.
Okay, Gordon. See you. Hey, listen, you.
What?
Hey, come here, you. I got a great trick we could play on Bert. You want
Yeah.
Listen.
Oh! Ah! Oh! Ooh! Oh! Ah!
Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling!
Oh! Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling! Ding-a-ling-a-ling!
Coming out!
Do-do-do-do-do! Do-do-do-do! Oh! Go!
Okay, give me the cookie.
Cookie!
No, wait.
Cookie!
Monster.
What?
Okay. Hey, listen, monster. Hey, listen. Yeah. Okay. Now, Bert's going to meet us here soon, see?
Yeah.
And he's going to come over here, and so you go down out of sight, see? And then, get this. And then, when you hear the bell ring, remember? When you hear the bell ring, you're going to come up and playing the flute, okay?
Cookie.
Oh, yeah, sure. Listen, here's a whole box of cookies, see? Now, you just come up playing when you hear the bell, okay? Okay. Okay, go down outside. Here comes Bert.
Okay.
Bop, 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 boop, scooby-doo.
Hey, Bert, Bert. Hey, look here.
What?
Hey, do you know what happens, Bert, when you shake a little bell like this?
Yeah, the bell rings.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And what else?
Well, what do you mean, what else? Yeah. If you shake the bell rings, that's all.
No, you know, Bert, I always thought when you shook a bell like this, it rang, and then a monster appeared playing a flute.
Ernie. Yeah. Ernie, old buddy, when you yeah. shake the bell, the uh-huh. bell rings. That's yeah. all. No oh. monsters, no flutes. No. Got that?
Well, gee, Bert, you know, maybe I'm wrong. You know, but there's only one way to find out. I'll just ring the old bell here, see?
Yeah.
And, just, ring the old bell, and, you know, maybe I better ring a bell a little louder, you know. I always thought that, when you shook a bell like this, a monster appeared playing a flute. I always thought that a monster appeared playing a flute.
Ernie, I hear you, Ernie.
Monster.
And you know what? I think you've gone bananas. See you later.
Hey, what happened?
Oh, whole box of cookies in mouth. Can't play flute with mouth full of cookies.
Oh, oh, no. Oh, oh.
Oh, Susan.
Hi, Bert.
Hi, Susan.
How are you?
Oh, I'm fine.
You know Ava?
Yes.
You know Ava, don't you, Big Bird?
Oh, yes. Hello, Ava.
Hi.
I know Ava.
Hi, Bert.
Hi.
Are you fine?
Just dandy. As a matter of fact, I'm so nifty, I have been drawing pictures. You know, I'm going to be an artist.
You know, he's taking this course, and he's really getting very good. May we see them?
Sure.
Oh,
here,
good.
Take a look at that.
Oh,
this is the pictures
Big
I drew.
Bird, this is terrific.
Thank you. When I get big, I'm really going to be a good artist.
We better tell him. Huh. Big Bird, this is great. Start on a clock, but it's not quite finished.
Oh, yes, I'm all done. It's all done.
No, dear, you're not, because you don't have any hands on your clock.
Well, people have hands.
Well, so do clocks.
They do?
You see, if you don't have hands, then you can't... Here, let me draw the hands on your clock.
Oh, all right, but you sure? Oh. Is that a hand?
Mm-hmm.
I thought its face looked a little blank.
Yeah, right.
Here.
Let's look at this next. Oh. Mm-hmm.
That's a house I drew.
Yes, we see.
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with this house, Ava?
Well, I guess a chimney's supposed to be on a roof.
Yeah, dear, you got the chimney coming out of the side of the house.
Oh, well, when I drew that, I had turned it around so that was on the top.
Oh, I see.
But then the house was on its side.
Big Bird.
I had trouble with that.
See, the door should be down here by the path. You have the door up on the second floor, and all the people who own this house would have to go in through the window.
Well, if they're tall like me, they could still go in through the door because they could...
Yeah, well, most people aren't as tall as you are, though.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Well, the next one's just about perfect.
Yeah, it's just about perfect, but it's not quite perfect because you didn't finish it.
I thought it looked like it needed something.
Well, you want me to help you? Ava and I will help.
Oh, sure.
Okay. One
arm. Oh. Oh, yes, another arm. Let's see.
Well, Big Bird, I can't draw as well as you can, but I'll just give you a little idea here.
Oh, I see. A foot?
Yeah.
Mm.
Here, now we have two eyes, two ears, two arms, two hands, two legs, and two feet.
1, 2, 3. Two turtles. One, two.
Two heads?
One, two.
Two hats.
One, two.
Two butterflies.
One, two.
Two chocolate cream pies.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Two.
Two. Two.
Two.
Two.
Two.
Two.
Two.
Come on, Ronald. Let's get a copy of the Sesame Street Sun. There are great newspapers around here. You know, if you get a newspaper and you... Hey. You hear? Listen. It's an airplane. Look up. Look. See it? How about that? It's making... it's the old skywriting airplane. It's going to write a letter for us. It's coming straight down. What do you think it is? An I?
No, an L.
An L? Why do you think it's an L? Right, an L is kind of straight, too. Look at it. It was an L. That was right, Ronald. That's pretty good. You're all familiar with L's, huh? Okay, how many letters can you think of, or how many words can you think of that start with the letter L?
Hold everything! Nobody has to think of anything that begins with the letter L. The Hooper Super Alphabet Maker will do it for you.
The Hooper Super... Alphabet maker
will do it for you.
It will.
Let me show you how it works. You turn the dial to the letter L.
Right.
You press this button. L. Lollipop.
Lollipop's an L word. Right. How about that? That's pretty good. Have a lollipop, Ronald.
Huh? I'll do it again. Light bulb.
Light bulb. That's another L word.
Right.
Oh, that light is out of sight. Look at that. A light bulb. That's an L word. Like that. Good. Hang on to that, Ronald. Be very careful of light bulb.
Do it again?
Do it again. One more time.
What happened? Doesn't work? Gordon.
Yes?
You don't have to laugh at me just because the machine didn't work.
Oh, Mr. Hooper, I didn't laugh at you. Did I laugh at you? No, no.
I didn't laugh.
No, you didn't laugh either, no.
Gordon!
Mr. Hooper, I didn't laugh.
No, I didn't.
I didn't laugh. No.
Well, then who was laughing?
Well, I think it's coming from
your machine.
That's ridiculous.
No.
A machine laughing.
Check it.
Check it out.
Look at both of them.
Look at the machine.
And try it and look at it.
Right.
The machine made another word. An L word.
It worked.
Laugh.
Laugh is an L word.
Yes.
Laugh is an L word. The machine worked. Laugh. Laugh.
That's
an L word.
L. Lunchbox. L. L, lunchbox. L.
You know what? Where this cake was made, don't you?
No.
At the bakery. It's called a babka. It's a kind of coffee cake. You know, sometimes I make my own cakes and bread and rolls. But most of the time, I'm kind of in a hurry, and so I buy my cakes or bread or rolls at the bakery.
My name is Shep. That's me with my mommy going into the bakery around the corner. Mommy wanted to get an apple cream pie for dinner. Sal, the baker, came out with some cookies, and I wondered what it would be like to be a baker. I thought about it real, real hard, and suddenly, I was a baker.
You ready to go to work?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Sal took me into the back where they make the pies, and I met Donato, one of the other bakers, and they showed me how to make an apple cream pie.
That's the thing, we gotta do pop and margarine.
Donato took some butter, and we weighed it and put it in a big bowl. Took some flour and we weighed that and put it in the bowl. After we put some sugar and other things in, we broke a whole bunch of eggs into another bowl. Then he started mixing them up, like Mommy does when she makes scrambled eggs. When everything was ready, Donato wheeled the bin over to a machine. When he turned it on, the machine started mixing everything together. Then he gave me the eggs to pour in. That was fun, watching them get mixed up with the other things.
How much does that have to go for?
5 minutes.
When it was finished being mixed, Donato said it was called dough. While we were taking the dough out of the bowl and patting it flat, Sal was cooking a whole bunch of apples so they would be all soft and juicy for the pie. When the apples were ready, Sal took the dough that Donato and I had made and started making the pie.
Put on the table.
He took a big handful of dough and rolled it out flat with the rolling pin. Then he took a little pan and rolled the dough into it.
Now we get the apple.
And filled it all up with apples. Then it was ready to be baked in the oven, so the dough would turn into pie crust and the apples would taste even better. After we took the hot pie out of the oven, Sal took a funny looking bag and filled it with whipped cream. Hole in one end, and Sal squeezed the whipped cream onto the top of the pie. Now it was finished, and boy, did it look good! We put it in a box and took it out to Mommy. And suddenly,
I'll bet Mommy never knew I helped bake that pie.
Come in. Hello there.
Hello.
Yes, what a surprise to see you. Why didn't you let me know you were going to come over? Can I get you something to eat?
Yeah.
What?
Cookie.
Cookie. Yes, well, listen, I don't have a cookie right now.
What?
I tell you what I do have. I have something even better than cookies. If you just let me know you were coming, you know. I can just whip up something here.
If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. Baked a cake. Baked a cake. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. How'd you do? How'd you do? How'd you do?
Cookie.
Had you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band. Greatest band in the land. If you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band and spread the welcome mat for you.
With my cookie.
I don't know where you came from.
Over there.
Cause I don't know where you've been.
All around.
But it really doesn't matter. Grab a chair and fill your platter and dig, dig, dig right in.
Oh, yeah.
If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake.
Go ahead.
Hired a band. Goodness sake, if I knew you were coming, I'd have baked the cake. How'd you do? How'd you do? How'd you do?
Hey, where'd it go?
Oh, it's cooking.
Cookie?
No, not cookie. It's cooking.
Well, hurry.
I'm hungry.
Where's the cake?
Oh, what's just a minute? I'll get it out.
It's in the box.
No.
Open the box. It's ticking.
There, it's done.
Now? Oh.
I wish
it was a cookie.
If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. Baked a cake. Baked a cake. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. How'd you do? How'd you do? How'd you do?
Oh, doing fine, doing fine, doing fine.
How'd you do? How'd you do? How'd you do?
Flowers, and Oscar's such an old grouch, he's not gonna like them. These are flowers for the kitchen.
Flowers?
Uh-huh.
Could I see them? You know, just to sniff them a little bit.
You want to smell the flowers? Do you like flowers?
Me? Yeah. Like flowers?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I wouldn't like flowers, you know that.
Oh, I didn't think so.
You gonna water them?
Oh, sure, when I go in the house, I'll water them. I'll put them on the table.
You got a watering can, haven't you?
Watering can?
Yeah.
No, but I don't need
You don't
that.
Have a watering
no,
can?
No, I don't need them.
Hey, you can borrow my watering can.
Oscar, what are you doing with a watering can?
Well, I keep a few flowers in my apartment from time to time.
You keep a few flowers?
Yeah.
Well, thanks a lot for the watering can. I'll see you.
Oh, Susan, wait.
What?
Do you have a hole?
But no, but Oscar.
You don't have a hole.
Look. My goodness.
Borrow my hole. You know, holes are handy to help take care of flowers, you know.
Yes, Oscar, I know, but you see, I won't need this because I don't grow my own flowers.
You don't grow your own flowers?
No.
Oh, well, just a second here. Here's a bag of seeds. Delphiniums.
Delphiniums?
They make a nice thing to put on the windowsill. Just plant those, and flowers will grow.
Oscar, that's very nice of you, but I don't have any place to plant delphinium seeds.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait, right here, okay? Here. Take this.
Flower pots.
There's
another. Oh, Oscar.
Just put some dirt in there.
Uh-huh.
And plant a little bit of seeds in there and water it with a watering can.
Yes.
And you're going to get flowers.
Are you sure you don't like flowers?
No, no, no.
You certainly have a lot of equipment here for somebody who doesn't like flowers.
Well, that's true. I don't like flowers, you see. So I keep a little greenhouse in my apartment here.
You don't like flowers, but you keep a greenhouse in your apartment.
Yeah, well, I leave the flowers around the house, you know, to make me grouchy.
Oh, to make you grouchy.
Yeah. So I grow my own flowers. Hey, you want to...
You grow your own.
Yep. You want to see a bunch? Just a sampling? Huh?
Yeah, let me see some flowers you grew in there.
Now, here's a bunch that I keep on the piano. They're for you. I want you to have them.
Oh, well, thank you very much, but I can't take your only bunch of flowers, Oscar.
Well, they're not exactly my only flowers.
They're not?
No, I have another bunch just like this on the kitchen table.
You do?
Yeah. And I have another bunch next to the bed.
You do?
And I have another bunch next to the telephone.
All to make
and
it
grouchy. And I have quite a few flowers in the apartment.
Wow, that's nice, Oscar. Thank you very much. They're much nicer than mine.
That's okay. I don't like flowers anyway. I don't like them. I have to go now.
Okay.
I have to water my daisies.
You know something? I think Oscar really does like flowers. He just doesn't want to admit it. Gee, flowers are so pretty. There's no reason for anyone not to like them.
Thank you.
this, as I was saying, is a Y. Now, there's a lot of words that begin with letter Y, and let me tell you some of the words that begin with the letter Y. Well, I can't think of any
letters
that begin...
Hi, Ronald.
Oh, hi, Bob. Bert.
What's up?
Well, I was telling Ronnie here about the letter Y.
That's a nice-looking Y you have.
No, thank you. But I can't seem to think of any words that begin with the letter Y. Maybe you could help us.
Well, would you really like me to help?
Yes, it would be a help, because neither Ronnie or I can seem to think of any words that begin with the letter Y.
You would like me to help?
I know one.
Yes.
How about that, Big Bird? That's a great start right there. Yes is a Y word.
It is?
Sure. Yes starts with the letter Y.
Wow.
You had one right off the bat.
Gosh.
Now let's see if we can find any more here. You know what? We're standing on one, Big Bird.
We are?
Yep.
Should we get off?
Nope, it's all right. Where are we on Sesame Street?
Well, we're in the yard.
There you go. Yard.
Yard!
Another Y word,
That's
right?
A Y word.
How about that?
Boy, we're
Let
getting
me
there.
Think now. You know, Big Bird, I have always admired your feathers.
You have?
They are absolutely beautiful feathers.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, no, they are. There's just one thing that puzzles me, though. What color are they?
Why, they're yellow.
There you go. And yellow is another word, right, Ronald? That starts with Y.
Hey, they are yellow, and that's a Y word. Hey, Ronnie, that's another Y word.
That's three of them right
yeah.
there.
Yeah. Right. Oi, I couldn't have thought of those if I'd thought about it for a year.
How long?
A year.
A year?
There's another Y word for you, Big Bird.
Thanks.
Year is a
year?
Y word?
Sure, year starts with Y.
Four.
Oh, my goodness. Look, hey, we've got a lot of Y words. Gee, all those words begin with the letter Y. Yippee!
You know, I have this picture that my friend drew of the jungle, but the thing that makes it such a groovy picture, all the animals are hidden in the foliage of the trees. And I want you to look at it really up close and try and see how many of the different animals you can find hidden in the jungle. Who sees an animal? Renee?
A snake.
Where's the snake?
It's right here.
Right, in the trunk of the palm tree. There's the snake. Ava?
Well, I see the bird.
The bird? Where's the bird?
Right on top over
with
there.
With the long neck. He looks like Big Bird with that long neck, right?
Yes.
What else do you see? Renee, you see anything?
A giraffe right here.
Okay. How did you see the giraffe right away? You saw his
well,
spots,
they're not
right?
usually stones hanging in the air.
Yeah, okay. So you saw the spots and his long neck. Mm-hmm. Now, what else do you see? Yes, Renee?
I see a zebra.
Where's the zebra?
Right here.
Oh, yes. Now, he's a little hard to see because he's part of the leaf. But here he is with his stripes. These don't look exactly like the animals, but they're sort of like the animals so that they can be part of the foliage, you know, the leaves on the trees and everything. So you have to use your imagination a little bit.
Yeah.
You have to use your imagination to find a couple of the others that are a little better hidden. Ava, what do you see now?
Well, I see a monkey.
Where's the monkey? He's cute. Monkey. He's grinning at us. Look. See the monkey just smiling with his eyes, doing. He's sitting up in the tree looking out. What else do you see?
Well,
Renee?
I see a porcupine right there.
Okay. What's the outstanding characteristic of the porcupine? What do you see on the porcupine right away? You see his little needles. Face, and then you see all his porcupine quills, they're called. Mm-hmm. Yes, sweetheart?
Well, I see him a big elephant.
Where's the elephant?
Right over there.
All right, now he's kind of hard to see because he's part of the tree here. He's got his trunk up in the air, reaching for a leaf, and there's his ear, and there's the big elephant standing right there. Renee, what else you see?
A lion.
The king of the beast, yes. With his, see the leaves make his mane, all the hair that's around. Yeah, wow, you kids really did well.
I was just looking at a book that I'd like to read for you. It's called Clyde of Africa. Now, Clyde is a little baby lion cub, about 3 months old, and he lives in Kenya. That's the eastern part of Africa. All his friends are there, too. Here's the story. Once in Africa, there lived a lion cub named Clyde. Clyde kept himself busy. In fact, he kept himself very busy every day chasing balloons. He had a great time with that balloon. Give it a little nudge with his nose and hit it with his paw. Sometimes he liked playing with potatoes. Roll over in his back, hit it with his paw. Guess he was playing baseball with a potato. Sometimes he liked to climb up in the tree and chew on branches. And he even liked corn on the cob. Other times, why, he just liked to go down to the lake and watch the swans floating very quietly on the lake. But one hot summer afternoon, he was lying on a rock and feeling very, very bored with himself. And Clyde discovered something new. Now, it sort of began with a yawn. And then, well, it went from a yawn into sort of a cough. And pretty soon he stood up on his feet and he roared. I bet that really surprised Clyde because he had never roared before in his whole life. Well, he was so excited he turned around. And he roared in the other direction. Well, I tell you, he was so pleased with his new discovery that he ran to tell the whole world about it. He ran down the road and jumped over a stream. And finally he stopped and came to a flower. He looked at the flower for a while. And he laughed and he just decided that he would roar again right at that flower. And then he came upon a lake. He looked in the lake at himself and got a little closer and had a drink of water out of the lake. Then he thought again and took a big deep breath and he roared again. Well, pretty soon he met an old friend of his, a baboon with whom he used to play. They had a game called Pull the Tail of the Lion, and their other favorite was Bite the Tail of the Baboon. There's Clyde biting his tail. They had a great time. But this time, when the baboon said, "Hey, Clyde, come on and play," Clyde just sat up and looked at the baboon and he roared at him. Well, this took the baboon very much by surprise because, well, he had never heard Clyde roar before. Then Clyde walked down the road looking for bigger and better things to roar at. He hid in the long grasses and sniffed the breeze that blew across the veldt. That's what they call the big grassy plains in Africa. He lifted his head above the grasses and he saw a wildebeest grazing on the veldt. He carefully crawled toward the wildebeest and waited for just the right moment when the wildebeest was eating a fine mouthful of veldt grass. And then he took a big, big breath and he roared! Well, the wildebeest jumped into the air and was about to run for cover when he said to himself, "Hey, that doesn't sound quite like any lion I've ever heard." And he turned around for a good look. But when he saw who had roared at him, he chased Clyde clear off the veldt and back into the tall grasses. He knew he didn't have to be afraid of little Clyde. So Clyde lay in the grasses and he thought to himself, "Boy, you've just got to be careful whom you roar at when you're not quite a lion." And as the African afternoon grew later, and Clyde was beginning to feel, well, a little lonesome, he saw a tall giraffe, which is the tallest animal in Africa and the quietest. In fact, it doesn't make a sound at all. So Clyde climbed quietly up on a rock, and when he was high enough to reach the giraffe, instead of roaring at it, what do you think he did? He kissed its nose. You know, that was a very smart thing to do because the giraffe kissed Clyde right back with a long, pink, wet tongue that felt very, very good on a hot African afternoon. And then when night came, Clyde went back to his rock. He lay down for a while and he thought about what he'd learned about, well, about roaring and about not roaring. And in his dreams that night, he went to sleep, and he roared! Hey, that's kind of a nice story. I'll bet old Clyde is still roaring at everything in sight.
Let me see now. I'll take the tape. Good boy! Press it down real good. Now. And now.
Buddy. Buddy, what are you doing?
Oh, just sitting around, Jim.
Buddy, what is that?
Come on, Jim. You know what that is. That's your finger.
I don't mean my finger. I mean, what is that on your forehead?
Oh, that's my money.
And why is your money on your forehead?
So I'll know where it is. That's a nice, safe place to keep money.
That is the silliest thing I have ever heard in my life. Buddy, that's no place to keep your money.
Sure it is, Jim. Right there. That's a safe place.
Buddy, can't you think of another place to keep your money than your forehead?
Well, to tell you the truth, Jim, I did worry about that. I tried. Matter of fact, I tried first pasting it across my eyes like that. But you know, it's a problem when you do that. You keep bumping into things.
That's not what I mean. I mean, can't you think of a safe place? Think. It's very important.
Safer than here?
Safer than there, sure. There's got to be a safer place than that to keep your money.
Well, that's going to be a tough one.
Let's see now. Hold everything.
Uh-oh.
Aha.
Uh-oh.
Buddy, what is this?
Oh, Jim, that's a piggy bank.
Sure it is.
Matter of fact, you know, that's about the safest place in the whole world to keep things, you know, that you don't want to lose and you always know where they are. All you have to do is just drop them right in this little hole here in the top of the piggy bank, see? And then you got them on the inside. And if you want to take them out, you have a key, see? And you just take this key. Watching? Are you looking?
I sure am.
All right, you take this key and you just stick it right in the bottom, undo it, and then you take them out, see?
Buddy, didn't you just finish telling me that this piggy bank is the safest place in the whole world to keep things in when you don't want to lose them?
Jim, I just told you that.
Well, you know what I'm going to tell you now?
What?
I'm going to tell you to take your money off your forehead and put it right into the piggy bank where it'll be safe and you'll always know where it is. Right in there. Safest place.
Boy, Jim, you did it again. That's
sure
right. All I have to do is take the money off my forehead.
That's it.
And put it right in. There's a nickel.
There's one nickel.
Mm-hmm. A penny.
A penny.
And another penny.
You got a lot of money, buddy.
I got 7 cents. That's a nickel and two pennies right there in the old piggy bank.
Yes, boy. Now we know where they are.
Anytime I want to take them out, Jim, see, all I have to do, you know, I want to spend a little ice cream or something like that. I like ice
Not
cream.
Not before your dinner, though.
No, never before. When I want to take them out, all I have to do then is take the key and unlock the bottom and take my money out.
Get your money.
Mm-hmm.
Good boy.
Then, Jim.
What is it?
What happens if I lose? How do I get the money out of the bank if I lose the key?
Uh-oh. Buddy, for once in your life, you've had a good idea. We have to find a safe place to keep the key so you'll never lose it.
That's it. We got to find a safe place to keep the key so I...
Hold it.
Hold it. Wait a minute.
Jim's got an idea.
No. Buddy's got the idea, Jim.
What?
All you have to do is take this key right here, you see, and paste it right on the forehead.
Buddy,
I know where that is.
That's
right
not
there.
A good
all
idea.
The times
I have a better idea. All you have to do to put the key in a safe place is to put it in the safest place in the whole world that Buddy and Jim know to keep things. Where is that?
Where is it?
I'll show you where it is. Give me that key.
Oh.
We're going to take the key and we're going to put it in the old safe piggy bank.
That's it, Jim.
That's the answer.
You did it again.
Sure.
Oh, boy. Good boy.
Okay, Buddy. Well, I'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, Jim.
What?
I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, buddy. So long.
So long. Boy, is he smart. Yep, he figured it out. Now I got the money in the piggy bank where it's safe, and I got the key in the piggy bank where it's safe. And now all I have to do anytime I want to take my money out of the piggy bank is just to take the key that's in there and... Oh, Jim.
Hiya. My name is Kermit, and today I'm here to talk to you about walls.
Now, a wall is sort of hard to explain, but everybody knows what a wall is. See that right there? That's a wall. That's a wall. All right. Now that's a wall. Now, before this wall was here, I could walk way back up here, and I could keep on going. You see, I could walk way far back there, but I can't any longer because there's this wall here. But anyhow, that's another wall. Well, before that wall was there, see, I could walk way off to this side, but I can't any longer because there's a wall there. But I can still walk off to, well, you see, anyhow, before these walls were here, I could walk off to this side, or I could walk off to this side. But anyway, there's no wall in front of me, so I can see you and I can talk to you. But if there were a wall in front of me, I couldn't talk to you if there were a wall in front of me. And so that's all I've got to say about walls.
Walls. W. A. L. L. S. Walls. Tall walls. Walls stop things. Walls you never thought of. Side of a fishbowl, a box. A screen is a wall. A newspaper. Oven walls. A blanket can be a wall. A road divider. Walls are for playing games.
How about that, Ronald? Big ones, short ones, little ones, tall ones, wide ones, fat ones. You know there are that many walls? You didn't, but now you know, right? Hey, look up. Look. See that? He's back. Plain, writing a letter. Right?
G.
You say a G. You say a G. What do you say, Ava?
I think it's an O.
You think it's an O. All right, Ava, you might be right because it's making a circle and it's coming close together. What other letter could it be?
G.
Could be a C.
Maybe, but I think it's
G. You think it's more like a G. But if it's going to be a G, it's got to make another line, right?
It's a C.
It's a C right now.
It's no, a G. It's a,
yeah, but it's a C right now, Ronald. But now it's a G. Now it's a G. Now it's a G. Now it's a G. How about that? Plane writing letters up in the sky and it made a G. Okay.
I was right.
You were right. Let's drop some G words on us real fast. How about the word glove?
Glove.
Yeah. Good one. That's one.
Glass.
Glass. That's another. Oh. Wait. That glass. One more. Grass.
Grass.
Okay. That's three. All right. Now I want the three of you, Renee, Ronald, and Ava, give me one more word.
That goodbye.
One more word. That's the word. Goodbye. See you later. Come on, let's go.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G, L, and Y, and by the numbers 2 and 3. Clyde of Africa was written by Michael Mason. Photographs by Ken Heyman. Published by the Macmillan Company. Copyright 1963. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.